Are you losing your hair?
Or is your hair so curly that it is difficult to comb?
Well, if either one of these scenarios apply to you, then you may be lacking the straight hair growth gene. So, stay tuned to find out more in this episode.
Hello folks, welcome to our show. In this Gene Spotlight show, we strive to bring you regular insights on DNA that you never knew you had, in a fun and entertaining way.
Yep, please subscribe to our growing channel and do get updated on our new episodes released fortnightly. So hit that big red button below right now.
Alright, in this fortnight's episode, let's talk about one of the most important features in our body that makes us attractive.
Yes, we are talking about hair. Or more specifically, the hair on your head.
Hey Josh, that's not fair. You guys can only talk about hair on your heads. But look at me, I have hair all over the place. And the longest part of my hair isn't even on my head.
Kevin, I hear you. But we humans do have auxiliary hair on other parts of our bodies too. Just that our body hair is quite short and fine, so it is not that visible from afar. And for the rest, well, these areas are normally covered, so you won't get to see them much. Unlike you bears, who show off your thick hair or fur all the time.
Well, it ain't my fault that I was born sexy. In any case, folks, do you know why hair is so important? And why do people spend so much time and money grooming it?
Allow me to answer that, guys. Our hair, after all, is our best accessory. And for most people, a well-kept, thick head of hair brings added good looks to an already good face. To a certain extent, it will add character to your personality and even embodies your identity. And furthermore, apart from the aesthetic value of hair, it has biological importance as well. The hair on your head is the first line of defense against the sun's UV rays. The same goes with the hair on the body. Eyebrows and eyelashes also help protect the eyes from UV rays as well as dust and irritants. Apart from keeping the head protected from harmful rays, it also protects your head against excessive heat by helping to circulate the air around the scalp and shutting out ambient heat. Your hair acts as a natural insulator by trapping body heat and keeping it close to the skin, which helps to prevent a drop in body temperature.
Wow, I bet you folks didn't know that hair is so important, eh? No wonder so many of you are so concerned about hair loss.
Yeah, and did you guys know that globally, 2/3 of men are already affected by male pattern baldness, with 40% experiencing noticeable hair loss by the age of 35?
Wow!
And that is the topic of the show today, guys. One of the genes that influence the thickness and straightness of your hair is the EDAR gene, or as we call it, the straight hair growth gene. And research has shown that variation in this gene are associated with the thickness and straightness of scalp hair, particularly in East Asian populations. In fact, the average strand of East Asian hair is about 30% thicker than that of Africans and 50% larger than that of Europeans. That is why most Asians have thick and straight hair.
Wow, that's interesting information. Apart from East Asians, I also know a race with thick, straight hair. You want to guess what?
Oh, which race is that, Kevin?
It's Chewbacca and his race of Wookiees.
You are right. They certainly have an abundance of beautiful, long and straight hair.
So what does the EDAR gene stand for? And where is it found in our body, Josh?
Well, EDAR stands for ectodysplasin A receptor, and it codes for a protein that plays an important role in the development of hair, skin, nails, teeth, and sweat glands. While a good expression of the EDAR gene will create thick and straight hair, variants of the EDAR gene will create thinner and more curly hair. In some instances, a disrupted EDAR gene can lead to early hair loss and even total baldness.
Ouch, that's tough. However, worry not, folks. Hair loss is not just decided by genetics. It is also influenced by lifestyle and the environment as well. Stress and diet in particular have a strong influence in the health of your hair. In fact, there are examples of bears being so stressed out by being kept in captivity in zoos that they lost all their hair. But thankfully, after they are released back to the wild and with proper nutrition, they regain back their thick fur.
Yes, Kevin, I agree that lifestyle and diet plays a big part in maintaining our hair health. So, even though we may find that we are losing our hair now, there are corrective actions that we can take to remedy that.
Nice. Listen closely to these tips, guys.
And so, listen up. Number one, you can keep your hair in a healthy condition through maintaining a healthy diet. Look for foods that are rich in iron, biotin, silica, and zinc. In fact, if you have curly hair, some kinds of hair products can help to straighten your hair too. Number two, keep your hair and scalp moisturized. Hair mask and deep conditioning treatments will help provide moisture to the scalp and enhance the strength of your hair follicles. But avoid those with harmful chemicals in them like sodium chloride and polyethylene glycol. If you want to, try lavender and peppermint essential oils to encourage hair growth and hair straightening. And number three, avoid hot showers. Overly hot showers can cause damage to the scalp by stripping it off the essential oils that helps to protect it, causing dryness and inflammation. In fact, if you blow dry your hair with cold air instead of hot air after your bath, you will get straighter hair too. And lastly, number four, try scalp massage. Some studies have suggested that scalp massage has the potential to increase hair density by improving blood circulation to the scalp and hair follicles, as well as increasing the activity of genes known to promote hair growth. An additional benefit is that massage helps to lower stress levels, another factor relating to hair loss.
Wow, those are great tips, folks. So if you think you are losing hair, or you want to find natural ways to straighten your crowning glory, do try these tips out.
Indeed. And with that, we have come to the end of our show today, guys. If you know anyone who is struggling with messy hair or hair loss, do share this video with them.
Yep, we hope you like our episode today. And remember, we release a new episode every fortnight and with new DNA, health, wellness, and fitness promotions every month. So please consider to subscribe to our channel and get updated on new content and new promotions regularly that may change your life.
And so, till next time, people, have an awesome week ahead. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.